नित्यानंदेश्वर समारंभां नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, owners of Sarvajna Peetha, everyone sitting with us all over the world through Nityananda TV, Sadhana TV, two-way video conferencing, having Nayana Deeksha, cities sitting with us, having two-way video conferencing, having Nayana Deeksha, Los Angeles Adinam, Toronto Adinam, Seattle Adinam, Mexico City, St. Louis Adinam, Kuala Lumpur Adinam, Oklahoma Adinam, Oman Adinam, Guadalupe Adinam, Phoenix Adinam, Ohio Adinam, Charlotte Adinam, Rubini, सिंगापुर आदीनम, हैदराबाद आदीनम, रोम इटली, हैदराबाद गुप्तकाशी, इंद्राणी न्यूजर्सी, दुबई आदीनम, ट्रिनिडाड टोबैगो, ह्यूस्टन आदीनम, पुदुवई आदीनम, डोंकास्टर यूके, सेंट लुईस मैनचेस्टर एंड सम मोर सिटीज, Nityananda Nagar Abidhi, Singapore Adinam, and some more cities are joining. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. I'll expand on Kathopanishad, the introduction story. Please understand, it's very beautiful story, the introduction story. There was a time aliens were not aliens to us. Please understand, when your mind divides, even the other country people are called aliens. Now, this is the extreme stupidity. Some of the so-called developed countries call the other country citizens as aliens. The abusive nature and arrogant nature. See, I am not saying that what India is suffering by the Bangladeshi invaders, that should be allowed. No, I am not supporting that. See, if somebody wants to come from Bangladesh and live here, be part of our society, I don't think I have any right to oppose. But when they come here, try to harm our villages, run a riot, do criminal acts, then we have all the right to protect ourselves. But no way we have a right to give them the title aliens. We have no right to give the title aliens. There was a time we were so vast in our heart, the Satya Yuga, even aliens were not aliens. They were able to smoothly, easily come and go. We were able to go to their space and come. That was the time this story happened, where a 7-year-old kid can straight walk up to Yama's abode. Yama comes showing his form clearly. Aliens were not aliens. in those days. I hope again the same space will come back. This story, beautiful story, I'll just give an outline of the story and then explore the meaning, sacred secrets hidden in this story. The outline of the story is one Vajashravas, king, became very old. He had a son, Nachiketa, just 7-year-old kid, less than 7 year old kid. This king wants to have heavenly pleasures after he dies due to his insecurity about life. And the priest, Vedic priest, recommends certain ritual from the Vedas to be done to achieve the heaven. But unfortunately, this king, who is so greedy, who is not ready to understand the context of the ritual, started doing the ritual more in a business sense. Because he does not understand the context, he was trying to do more as business instead of giving away the best things he has. He started giving away the cows, which are literally useless for the person who receives, because they can't give milk, they can't give birth anymore, they have become really old. In Hindu tradition, we don't kill the cows. Even if they become old, we maintain them. So he gave away the cows, which are really old, which is in the space stage where you need to maintain them. So he started giving away those kind of cows. Upanishad poetically describes, the cows have drank enough water and no more power to drink. They have finished eating grass enough and thus have aged. They can't eat anymore. And their milk has been milked and they cannot yield any more milk. And they have lost their power of senses and organs to give birth. So he started giving that kind of cows. Without context, he was trying to do the ritual. So Nachiketa, his son, fortunately, who is not yet developed any root pattern, goes and talks to the father and asks him about this whole thing. This is the scene Upanishad describes. Now I'll explain the every sacred secret Upanishad is trying to describe through this story, introduction story. The very space with which Upanishad describes this story is so beautiful. Even though we have divided ourselves so deeply, we moved far away from the Advaita. See, the whole society, human society, claiming that people from other planets are aliens is a very big drop from the Advaitic space of oneness, then in that you claiming people from other countries as aliens is a one more big drop, and then you claiming people from other community or religion as aliens is one more drop. This is the way we go into the lower and lower worlds. We are becoming a lower and lower world. Even though we moved far away from the original Advaitic space, the story is still relevant to us. First, Nachiketa, hero of the Upanishad, filled with sattva, the pure seeking, less than 7-year-old kid who has not even developed root pattern. Vajashravas, the king who has mastered all the tactics of a ruler, who has conquered many smaller kingdoms and who knows all the nuances of business, I tell you, king should establish his authority only by power, never through business sucking the citizens and sucking the wealth out of citizens. When these two overlaps, that is abuse of power. Vedic tradition is very clear. All the four major powers of the human society: one, knowledge; second, weapons; third, money, wealth; fourth, land. All these four was kept separately to different four groups, so that the decentralization of the power was always maintained. There is no authoritative governance. There is always a democracy. Even if there is a king, he has to be a benign ruler, benign authority, benign autocracy. He can't be just doing what he wants, because knowledge is in a different, knowledge is with a different group, wealth is with a different group, weapons are with a different group, and land is with a different group. But when the king tries to play the game of a businessman, he messes up his life and the life of the citizens. Here this fool, Vajashravas, is trying to do business. He developed stupid business mentality. Maybe he must have been a powerless guy. Internally, he must have never felt fulfillment being a king. He must have been still feeling empty. So that is why trying to encroach upon the space of wealth and developed foolish business mental setup. I tell you, you need to really, really dig in, look in, and find out whether the knowledge is going to give you fulfillment, or wealth is going to give you fulfillment, or weapons, the power is going to give you fulfillment, or having the large land is going to give you fulfillment. You need to take clear decision. But this guy, I can say a typical king who is confused. He himself is confused about what is going to fulfill him. He is not clear about what is going to fulfill him. What fulfills him? Otherwise, a king developing a business mentality is the most cheapest thing. He should know he owns people who owns wealth. Understand? When you are fulfilled with knowledge, you know you own people who owns wealth, you own people who owns land, you own people who owns political power. You just know. That is the power of knowledge. Same way, when you are fulfilled with the power of weapon, the political power, you just know. You own the people who own knowledge. You own the people who own wealth. You own the people who own land. When you feel empty inside, insecure, who knows, these fellows with wealth, I don't think they will listen to me. I don't think I really own them. Better let me own the wealth directly. That is when the mixing of castes happens, as Krishna mentions in Gita. Understand? He says, mixing of castes, jati nashta, chaos in the varnashrama dharma, confusion in the varnashrama dharma happens when one guy feels insecure and tries to possess the other mental setups. Varnashrama dharma is the most abused concept in Hinduism. All the anti-Hindu forces used these 4 or 5 concepts to attack Hinduism left and right, abuse Hinduism left and right. One is Varnashrama Dharma, another one is Sati, the women committing suicide when the husbands die. We need to look in a little bit. You won't find a single reference of a Hindu king, even if he conquers other kingdom, disrespecting women or raping them, imprisoning them or abusing them or using them. You won't find a single reference. Look into the history.
Our women carried the best DNA developed by our rishis. Our kotra is nothing but a code word for a special DNA layers. Please understand, our rishis have mastered the science of inserting the specific biomemory into a specific DNA layers. So our gotra is the code word for those special DNAs. When a child is born in certain gotra, this set of knowledge is already learnt by him. You just need to provide that ambience, he will recover, he will start expressing everything. Please understand, when I was 7, I started reciting the whole Ramayana, Mahabharata, all the 20,000-30,000 verses of Devaram Tiruvasagam by heart. When I was 7, I started reciting all these. I did not even learn language or script. I did not even know Tamil script or Devanagari script, in which all this knowledge is there. I was not even able to read Devanagari script or Tamil script, but I can recite all the thousands of verses from Valmiki Ramayana, from Vyasa's Mahabharata, from Devaram Tiruvasagam. The moment that ambience was provided, whatever was in the DNA, in the biomemory, started expressing. So the kotras are the code word for DNA. Stealing our women was the worst stealing done. That is the worst conspiracy done against Hinduism. Because the best DNA, which our ancestors built with so much of sacrifice, this is what Krishna wants. Adharma bibhavat Krishna pratushyanti kulastriyaha strishu dushtasu varshneya jayate varna sankaraha. By prevalence of impiety, O Krishna, the women of the family become corrupt, and women becoming corrupted, O varshneya, there arises intermingling of castes. Shankaro narakayaiva kulagnanam kulasyacha patani pitaro hyesham lupto pintata takakriyaha. Confusion of caste leads to hell of the slayers of the family, for their forefathers fall deprived of the offerings of the pinda, the rice ball and water. There are many verses about this in the Gita. These words are actually uttered by Arjuna to Krishna. But this was the common prevalent concept in those days. Please listen. We need to look into this whole community system with the idea of investigation, not with the idea of abusing. Be very clear. We are a civilization created for enlightenment. When somebody is not complete in this Janma, he will take the birth in the next Janma in the same family and ambience and will start where he has left and continue his journey. So our civilization is created for that. these invaders, if you don't believe in next Janma, who are you to talk about our civilization? Anti-Hindu forces are the most dangerous forces for planet Earth, because neither they have knowledge nor they are interested in investigating. All they know is the brutal weapons, turning their weapons to the people who are investigating, contemplating. I tell you, all the fellows who conquered this world with weapon and torturing this world with weapon, your time is over. Thanks to the internet revolution, thanks to the next generation youngsters who started seeking, investigating, when a human society largely starts seeking, investigating, that is the age for us, people with knowledge. All the barbaric techniques, tactics, gone, over. Neither your atomic weapons nor your chemical weapons are going to be useful. It is waste of your resource. Producing more and more may give you little pseudo-security. But neither all these are going to be useful, nor you are going to achieve anything with all this. The age of controlling the human population through weapons is over. Thanks to next generation, started seeking knowledge. Thanks to the next generation, started questioning. Thanks to internet revolution, thanks to all the IT industry for making knowledge as a foundation for lifestyle. So now, even a middle class person, if he wants to know about anything as simple as where to buy organic vegetable to, how to awaken your third eye, straight they go for Googling. So the humanity has started looking in the direction of investigation. I tell you, this is the best thing can happen to humanity. Please understand, sitting in the land which has suffered most number of invasions and brutal attacks, like Hinduism, this city is the most brutally attacked, invaded city in the history. We are the largest oldest highest in all aspect civilization. Even before 2000 years, largest, highest, oldest. Of course, still we retain the title oldest and highest, but we lost the title largest because of constant invasions. Constant invasions. It is time now. World is ready to listen to us. I tell you, this International Yoga Day is marking of Satya Yuga started. It is actually a marking of Satya Yuga starting. I'm really going to put a lot of effort on studying these gotras and DNAs. Why those traditions of gotras need to be maintained. And I will also prove, scientifically establish, picking up the kids from each of the gotras and making them demonstrate that knowledge branch. And prove that those memories are stored in that layer of DNA of each gotra. I know that is the reason these anti-Hindu forces are terrorized by me, who doesn't have anything other than this 4-inch tongue. I do not have any weapon. I don't have anything. Just the 4-inch tongue where Mahadevi Saraswati is sitting. I'll contribute to the world by reviving these great truths. Why our rishis established this gotra system and community system? Please understand, this discrimination of community system itself was imposed on us by invaders. Please understand, the Gayatri Mantra, which is chanted by all the Brahmins, is revealed by a Kshatriya, Vishwamitra. The Vyasa, who is worshipped by all the Brahmins, is the son of a boat fisherwoman, Shudra. If we want the Brahminical superiority to be established, don't we have that much of intelligence just to change the history? Instead of fisherwoman, we could have said one great Brahmin lady, Brahmin virgin lady, was sitting in the boat along with the fisherwoman. Vyasa was born for that lady. How much time it would have taken for us to change the history two line? We were not interested in Brahminical supremacy. Understand, we were not interested in establishing any supremacy or authority. We were simply straight. Please understand, in every temple, all the Adi Shaivas have to worship. Adi Shaivas are the purest Brahmins and respected even by Brahmins as higher than the Brahmins. Please understand, the Adi Shaiva Brahmins are respected by the whole Brahmin community as higher than the Brahmins, because they take care, maintain the temple and do the seva to the gods, goddesses directly. So Adi Shaivas are respected higher than the Brahmins, means they are, even in the Brahmin community, they are step higher. They have to worship every day the saints of Hindu tradition. In that saints, at least 20 of them are Dalits. Understand? I just wanted to tell the India's Dalit brothers and sisters, Hinduism never alienated you. You have been taught wrong history and you have been poisoned. This whole thing actually need to be revisited. How the sati was forced on us. Why will a Rajput queen, till yesterday she lived as a queen, respected, revered even by king. Please understand, in the Saptapadi, the fourth vow is you will not force yourself on the other person physically or psychologically whenever the other person is not ready. The fourth vow in the Saptapadi, when she has been living like that, even in the marriage, treated with so much of respect and sacred way, why will she want to live being tortured by brutally raped, abused, tortured by the beast, fully drunk? Why will she want to live facing that kind of a torture every day? So burning herself was the best option. She was left out. Sati was forced upon our women by the rapist invaders. Please understand, our women are so graceful. There is a clear writing in the Rajputs' history why they chose of burning themselves instead of drinking poison. Drinking poison and all could have been very less painful death. Burning is a worst painful death. Why they chose that worst painful death of burning themselves? They are giving a clear answer. Even after death, no one should touch our body. If we drink poison and die, there is a possibility. And you need to know, very recently, I was talking to one of my doctor. She was telling me some of the government hospital secrets. In the mortuary, when dead bodies are brought, some of the workers, imagine, I'm just leaving the dash, dash, dash. Understand, our Rajput women, they are very clear and they know these devils will do anything because they are so filled with lust and uncontrollable violence. They don't even want their body to be touched even after death. They don't want their body to be touched even after death. That's why they burnt themselves. Sati was forced on us. The caste discrimination concept was forced on us. Please understand. The Gotra system was created to properly protect and keep the Y chromosome and avoid genetic disorders. Understand? To avoid the genetical disorders and to protect and preserve Y chromosome, and above all, to protect all the major knowledge branches. Many of the knowledge branches have been preserved in the DNA. By God's grace, Mahadeva's grace, we are almost there. We are almost there. We just need to establish the laboratories and collect right people in those different fields to establish what I am talking about. Because as far as the power is concerned, the power needed to awaken the DNA layer and power needed to awaken your third eye is one and the same. The energy which I am directing towards your Anandaganda, towards your third eye now, the same energy if I direct it towards your Anandaganda, your DNAs will open. So the energy required for your third eye awakening, energy required for your DNA awakening is one and the same. There is nothing different. So as far as the spiritual energy concerned, Mahadeva is graceful enough to already shower us with that spiritual possibility. We just need to develop the right outside infrastructure and establish what I am saying. I tell you, I can pick up kids from each gotra below 7 and make them recite the whole Veda branch. Belongs to that gotra who has not even read any script or heard anything from anybody. Just opening the DNA, I can make that kid recite the whole Veda of that branch. Each gotra took the responsibility of preserving one shaka of Vedas. I can make them recite. I'll do it and show. Till now, anything I claimed, I have not missed it. I took little time, but I demonstrated it. Now I'll do this. This is the way I will also bring all the lost Vedas back. Whatever shaka, whatever knowledge branches were lost, I'll bring them back. I'll put it on record. I'll get them all out. It is possible. I am not talking something about something which is not possible. The gotra system and the whole community system has a deep meaning. By the time I complete my satsangs on Upanishad,
I'll explain each aspects of Vedic tradition. I have not come just to revive Upanishads. I have come to revive the whole Vedic tradition. Everything should be revived. I also commit with you guys. I'll bring back the gotras and have 7 bank of gotras so that the future can decide which gotra they want, what kind of kids. I'll use the modern science to keep this unique DNAs developed and gifted to the world by our rishis. This is my humble offering to the rishis. Now the whole science is available. It is time we revive these sacred truths and gift it to the world. I tell you, many of the major developed countries will be interested in what I am doing, because many of the major countries which are interested in education and investigation and exploring have started turning towards the knowledge and sacred things, because all the developed countries have understood you can't control the human beings anymore by weapon. That age is over. That age is over. It is time we start developing the new humanity, new generation, by providing all the best things we had and we have. I self-impose time commitment of just 2 years, reviving this whole gotra and DNA connection, establishing. Because I need the infrastructure. For that only I'm saying 2 years. Otherwise, I would have decided less time. But I tell you, I'll do it. I'll really do it. Only then the world will understand why we had a community system, why we had a gotra system, why we marry only between some gotras and not between some gotras. Don't think I have spoken many things which is out of the Kathopanishad subject. No. I am describing the exact situation where Kathopanishad happened. I am describing the stage where this Leela happened. Only then I can describe the Leela. If I have not described the stage, you will not understand the whole Upanishad. So I am describing the stage. I am not out of subject or out of context. I'm talking about the subject and context which looks like out of context or out of subject. But which is really not. Actually, many of the foreign invaders came to India, not just for gold, wealth, that was their second priority, not just for gold and diamond, DNA, our women, who were the storehouse of DNA, the best DNA developed, the highest civilized, evolved DNA, it is for that they invaded. I'll continue to expand on these great truths. Not only expand, experientially establish soon all these truths I am revealing. I bless you all. Let you all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Advaita, the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.
ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದ ಧ್ಯಾನಪೀಠಂ, ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದ ನಗರ್, ಆಫ್ ಮೈಸೂರ್ ರೋಡ್, ಬಿಡದಿ, ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು. ಫೋನ್ 08027279999. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.